Okay, here's our play field. It's been dry for, you know, probably a day or so. And as you can see, that nice slick finish we had, that's gone. that's over with. And I always anticipate that. I know that this is just going to soak right back in to all the low spots, all the insert rings, all the wear. It's just going to absorb it. And particularly your open wood fibers, it's just going to soak in there. But now it's solidifying the wood. So what I've accomplished more than anything is I've given myself something I can sand. I've stabilized the surface so it's not too fragile. And now I can tape on it and rework it as needed. Now, I'm not going to go crazy repainting the entire play field, but I'm just going to hit all the highlights. Anything that looks ugly or bad or anything I can improve easily, I'll do that. And then, of course, I'll improve the things I have to improve, even if it's not easy due to wear. But, you know, I'm not going to sit here and turn this into a 40-hour playfield restoration. It's just not. It's just something that doesn't make any practical sense on this job. So we'll see how good we can get this one in, I don't want to say in a minimal amount of time or minimal effort, but without going too crazy. So that's what we're going to do. First things first, let's sand it. Get it sanded, and then we can figure out what we need to do from there.
I am just a cowboy, lonesome on the trail. A starry night, a campfire light. The coyote call. The howling winds wail. So I'll ride out to the old sundown. Up and down,
It's okay, amigo. Just let me go. Riding in the rodeo.
So first things first, I got a coat of clear on the apron, so I got to repaint that thing. It's a mess. I know I said something about it. I don't know if I ever showed it, but there it is. It's pretty scratched up throughout the entire apron. So it's going to take some cuts and some painting to get out ahead of that. Same thing there. I threw a coat of clear on the arch. I'm probably going to dust that with some white base and clear it again, but I just thought, well, I'll go ahead and clear it and see what I got. The Playfield, that's coming along very well. I always tell people when I'm dealing with these old games, it's like, okay, you got somebody, you got a patient that's 50 years old. You can't make him look like he's 20 again, but you can probably make him look, you know, a lot better, like maybe 30, 35, you know, and that's where I'm at with this thing. So it's looking pretty good. My cuts look real good. They're not obvious. If I look hard for them, I can find them. But, you know, at a glance, you don't see any of my cuts. They look very good. And it's hard because, I mean, this thing's got these little teeny dots everywhere. And it's just a whole lot to try to deal with. And the saucer holes, those look a lot better already. I'm having a lifting issue with it. I had that here. And I lost the lettering for where it said advanced bonus. And I mean, I can only do so much. These things are, they're just fragile and they don't like the clear being put on them because the finish is so old and basically petrified in a way that when that clear gets on there, it will lift it. And so it's a challenge. And the only real alternative is just to say no to these, but I usually can work it out. So anyway, I had that issue there. And then I had another one pop up just this pass. And I'll show that to you in detail and talk about it real quick. You'll see kind of like that little square. What that is this had a blister in it, like maybe the clear had gotten under the original finish, not under my paint, but the original finish, and it started to get a blister. So what I did is I cut that out in a flap, flapped it back, dropped clear all in there, and then pushed it back down. And by doing that, that keeps it filled in. And then when I sand it flat the next time, it'll be nice and flush. And then I can probably just dust that same white on there one more time and it'll be gone. But just, you're constantly chasing. It's like filling holes in a boat. You know, you're just, as soon as you fix one, you plug one, another one blows out. But it's looking really good. And honestly, this is under a plastic. I could put this thing together. You wouldn't even know it's there, but I know it's there, so it's gonna bother me. But yeah, it's, other than that, everything looks great. So, and that's minor. Solid white, I can deal with that. I'd be horrified if it happened, like, you know, down here in this really busy artwork or somewhere like that. That would suck. But yeah, these things are a challenge, and that's what it's all about. So here we go, but it's looking really good.